Okay, continuing with the problem of pH changes, parts C and D. Once again, we are adding a small amount of HCl to 480 mL of the various solutions. So don't forget that the change in pH is going to equal the pH final minus the pH initial. All right, for starters, we have just weak acid in solution. All right, well, isn't there the shortcut formula that we can use sometimes? Where if we have a weak acid alone in solution, the hydronium concentration should be equal to the square root of the Ka times the original acid concentration. So I will use my handy-dandy pH table and look up the Ka of acetic acid, and it turns out to be 1.8 times 10 to the minus 5. My initial concentration is 0.10 molar. So plunking that into my calculator, I come up with 1.34 times 10 to the minus 3, and that's equal to my hydronium concentration. So I believe if I take the negative log of my hydronium concentration, which is equal to my negative log of 1.34 times 10 to the minus 3, I should come up with a pH of 2.87. Okay, well, that is my initial, so I will put that down there, 2.87. All right, what about my final? HCl is a strong acid. Acetic acid is a weak acid. And if you can remember from lecture, when you have a strong acid and you're adding it to a weak acid, you may remember this statement for the common ion effect. The common ion effect says we should just pay attention to the strong acid. So just look at strong acid. Now, we already actually got the pH of that on the other video, but, you know, just for duplication's sake, let me remind you that this is a dilution when we just focus on the strong acid. V2, there we go. So, concentration 1 is 2.1 molar. V1 is my 15 mils. I would like to know my ending concentration, and my V2 is going to be equal to the 480 mils of solution that came in with my weak acid plus my 15 mils that came in with my strong acid. So when I type that in, my concentration comes out to be 0.0636363, and that is equal to my hydronium ion concentration. And, of course, if I take the log of 0.0636363, I will get a pH equal to 1.20. So, that is my final pH. Alright, so 1.20 minus 2.87 should give me a minus 1.67. Okay, almost there. All right, we would like to add a little bit of acid to a solution that is 0.1 molar each in acetate and acetic acid. This is a weak base. This is the conjugate weak acid. Hey, don't we call that a buffer? I think we do. So, initially, I will just write pH initial should be equal to the pKa plus the log of base. This can be in moles or concentration, just stay in the same units for both, over acid. And my base is 0.10, my acid is 0.10, so the log of 1 I trust you know is 0. So my pH is actually equal to my pKa, which is 4.74. So let me set up the reaction like I usually do. I will say that delta pH is equal to pH final minus pH initial. And my pH initial, I know now, is 4.74. All right, let's see. What about after I start adding the HCl? HCl is an acid, so chances are it's going to react with base. So how about if I write my weak conjugate base and my hydronium, which comes from the HCl that I'm adding. And this has sort of already been discussed, the fact that this reaction is going to slam to the right to make HC2H3O2 aqueous and water. Okay. Now, what are my initial amounts? I actually have a lot of initial amounts. I have 480 mils of 0.10 molar, so that would be 48 millimoles here. My hydronium, I have 15 mils, and it is 2.1 molar. So that would give me 31.5 millimoles. And my acetic acid, I have 480 mils and 0.10 molar. So that would again give me 48 millimoles. And no water. All right. Once again, it's going to slam to the right. We'll treat it as a limiting reagent. So I seem to have less hydronium. So I think I should use all of that. So there we go. And I will subtract 31.5 millimoles on this side and add 31.5 millimoles on this side. So that's no hydronium. millimoles of base here and 79.5 millimoles of acid form here. Okay, once again, I have a weak base and I have the conjugate acid of the weak base. So I have the conjugate weak acid. All right, well, we still have weak base and weak acid present, so we call that a buffer. So once again, let's pull out that Henderson-Hasselbalch. pH is equal to pKa plus log of base over acid. So pKa is 4.74. My base is the 16.5 millimoles. My acid is the 79.5 millimoles. When I put that in my calculator, the value that comes out is 4.06. If I put 4.06 as the final pH minus 4.74, the change in pH is minus 0.68.